Let's take a look at all the weapons in Far Cry 5. I will show you all the categories, tell you how you can unlock them, while also showing some gameplay of awesome weapons in action. So if you enjoy that, then a like would be super appreciated, and let's go! As soon as you find a store in Far Cry 5, you can take a look at all the weapons you can unlock in the game. Ubisoft will probably add more to the live events that will happen every Tuesday in April, but this is what you'll be able to get at launch. The shop starts with a featured tab showing some special weapons that are really up there with the best weapons in the game. You could say that these are skins for the regular weapons we can unlock in the game, but if you just unlock this skin, this special version, you'll have the weapon as well. All these weapons are available for credits you just earn by playing, by looting the environments, and iron bars you can find in the world or buy with real world money. So we got like one of the best melee weapons here, the Optimism, a really nice sniper, the Shark Shooter M17, a regular rifle, the RZ, and a nice pistol. Before you buy the weapons, you can also see the stats, and we will see that the stats from these weapons with the skins will be the same for the regular versions we will see later on. You can also upgrade these stats by putting attachments on the weapon, for example like a red dot sight or an extra magazine. Moving over to the melee weapons, we got a shovel, a socket pipe, a bolted pipe, a baseball bat, but also an aluminum bat that is actually better than the other melee weapons. Then we got a spiked bat that you can unlock by getting to level 2 in the resistance bar, and you will see that way more weapons are restricted to your certain level on the resistance bar. Good to note is that most of the melee weapons you see here I unlocked by just picking them up from enemies, so totally do that because then they will be added to the shop. So even if you already got a great weapon, just pick up the weapon that you never saw before because then it will be added to the shop so you don't have to buy it. I can't wait to unlock these, the Brazed Knuckles, and here you see what I mean with getting to a total resistance level. So here I need 3 levels of the resistance meter in total. So when I unlock these, I will totally show them off in a video. Should be awesome. And the final melee weapon is the WAK. For pistols, we got some regular weapons, and what is good to note is that the pistols are always in the offhand, so you can always carry them around while also having a rifle. While for example, if you want a rifle and a shotgun, then you need to unlock the extra holster perk so you can carry them around at the same time. We got a Magnum, an SMG, the PS226, Scorpion, pretty cool, and the weapons I showed you earlier are probably weapons I could have picked up, but I did not yet. Moving on, we got the Magnum L. I need one more resistance level for that. We got the A99 and also the Sixter, looking pretty cool. The D2 double barrel shotgun style in the offhand, I like that. The M79, and I think that this is where we have the Shark Shooter variant for. Then we got the Magnum Cannon for 9 levels, so every bar has 3 levels, so that means that you simply have to complete all the regions to unlock this weapon. And then we also got the special D2 Sin Eater, and you get this one for defeating Faith in her own region. So that is pretty cool. Every time you defeat one of the family members of Joseph Seed, you get a signature weapon. The Shark, so a regular gun with an awesome skin. The Toaster, the Amendment 2, and one weapon I unlocked really early in my play session. A pretty cool weapon indeed. And then we got the Aerial Force gun from the Ace Pilot Pack you get with the deluxe edition of the game. And this Magnum is also included, so pretty good stuff indeed. Next up we got shotguns, starting with some regulars, M133, the M133M, the SBS for 4 levels. The familiar SPOS 12 is also in the game. And good to note is that if you meet the requirements for these weapons, so if you are high enough in the resistance bar, you still need to buy them. So you don't immediately unlock them, but you unlock them so you can buy them. We also got the M133MS weapon for 7 levels. And then some skins for the weapons we already saw. The Grand Slam, the Farmhand, and the one that I got, Flame Out. And yes, I love me some red and some gold. and this is really one of the best weapons in the game in my opinion. I want to do a video on all the weapons you need to get as soon as possible, and yes, this one is totally included. For submachine guns, we got the famous MP5K you get in the Ubisoft Club section of the game, so just go there, link your account, and you'll be able to unlock it. We got a regular MP5 in there as well, the MP40 for 4 levels, the MP4SD for 8 levels, and also the Vector Classic. My favorite class is the regular rifle, with one of the first weapons you get, the ARC. You also see a ton of enemies have this weapon. We also got more rivals, and if I pronounce these names not correctly, I'm sorry, but I hope I do it correctly. We got the 4570, the MS16, the really cool looking 4570T. Then we got another really cool looking weapon, the MS16 Trooper, and a great regular AK-47. You also got the AKM you unlock after 6 levels. Some skins for the weapons are there as well. We got the Shark, the Fall Ghost for the 4570, and I got this one, the White Tailor AKMS, another weapon that is insanely powerful. And then we also got another skin for the weapon called Warrior. So same weapon, other skin. The final weapon skin is part of the Digital Deluxe Edition, just like we got with the Magnum. So if you got one of these items, just go to the store, look for the weapon, and you will be able to equip it. For snipers, we got the ARZL, the 308 Carbine, the MBP.50, the ZA-50, and a special Jacob's rifle you get from killing Jacob Seed. It's a skin for the MBP.50, but that doesn't make it less cool. Other skins are another Shark one, we got the Old Flame for the Carbine, and the MBP.50 Gold and Steel that you also get in the Gold Edition, I think. So pretty insane that you can already unlock these weapons once you start the game. Then we go over to the Special Weapons tab, then we got some big machine guns and more, but first let's take a look at the machine guns, the M60, the M249 that you can also unlock immediately with a skin, the Militia, and I already used this in an early play session, and man, what a powerhouse this is. For the bows, we got a regular bow, the Slingshot, and I truly want to use that at one point. I'm really curious to see how that will shake out. We got the recurve bow, that is the best bow overall. And then if you got like the big game hunter pack that is part of the deluxe edition, then you also get this variant on the compound bow. There are two launchers in the game, the RPG-7 and the Red 4. And the Red 4 is looking very sick indeed. You can get a flamethrower in the game, which is pretty awesome indeed. And we also have the Magnopulsor, and I don't know what that is about. So you unlock this by doing a special activity in the game. And I can't wait to see what that weapon is about. Then we also got the Flames on Flames skin for the flamethrower. It is a suitable red skin. You probably knew that fishing is also a thing in Far Cry 5. We got the regular rod, a natural fishing rod, increasing the rate of fire and the handling. We also got a way better fishing rod, the Wonder Boy, you get from a special event. And last but not least is the Old Betsy fishing rod, where you need to beat each region's state records. So that's really awesome for people that are into fishing. There is an awesome reward at the end. So there you have it. All the weapons in Far Cry 5 you can unlock at launch. I will have way more in-depth looks at these weapons, the unique weapons, and way more. So totally subscribe for way more Far Cry 5 content coming your way. Check for example already my video on all the outfits in Far Cry 5 and all the perks you can unlock as well. Drop a like to support the channel. I will speak to you next time, and goodbye.